Hi everyone, welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to read data from a text file in three different ways. Now, let me open my Eclipse, and in my Java project, I'm just creating a new class. I will name it as read data from text file. Let's take a main method and then finish. So here I'm going to use two different classes. One is file reader and buffer reader. So that's approach one. So let me write one approach. In approach one, I'm using two different classes. What are they is? One is file reader. This is one predefined class. The other one is a buffer reader. Buffer reader, this is another class. So by using these two classes, I can read the data from the text file. Now, how to use these two classes? The first thing is we need to create a file reader object. Let's say file reader, let's say FR equal to new file reader, and here we need to specify the location of your file in which your data is present. Now in my location under C drive Selenium practice, inside this I have a test.txt file. We just open the file which contains the three lines of code. Now I want to read this data, so I need to copy this location and then specify here along with the name of the file, // file name is test.txt. So this is the name of the file. So file reader, we have to import from java.io. Now this will throw some exception, just add throws declaration, and file not found exception is added to the main method. So this is the first step. We have to create a file reader object where we have to specify the name of the file, location of your file along with the name of the file. In the next step, we have to create one more object for buffer reader, because this parameter we need to pass to the buffer reader object. So the next step is we have to create one more class, buffer reader. So I'll say buffer reader, let's say BR equal to new buffer reader. And here we need to pass this object, let's say FR we need to pass. Now import this buffer reader from java.io. And here, so now we have a predefined methods in the buffer reader class. By using them, we can read the data. So we have a multiple lines of data, right? So we have to read each and every line from the text file. So for that, what I can do is I'll just create one string variable str and make it as empty, or we can just leave this str as a string variable. Now I'll write a loop statement. So here, if you know how much content, how many lines are there, we can go for for loop. But here we don't know exactly how many lines are there. So most of the times in these cases, we will prefer to use while loop. So here, if we don't know the size, we can directly go for the while loop. So here, inside the while loop, I will write a method called, let us say, br.readline. So there is a method called br.readline. So br is buffer reader class object. And dot read line method will read the line from the text file, the first line from the text file. And if this line, if you don't have any line in the text file, it will return null. Okay, if there is a line in the notepad or text file, it doesn't return null. So it will return the line, the content. So here, which is not equal to null, I said. So br.readline, which is not equal to null. And this br.readline we have to store in string variable first of all, because this will read it will read the value inside the str. So br.readline will read the content from the text file, store that into string variable. And if this is not equal to null, and then I'll proceed further. Let me write properly. So while str, and here we are doing str is an assignment here. It is not a comparison. Okay. We are storing br.readline value in the str, and then I'm comparing str not equal to null. Okay. And then inside this while loop, I will write system.out.println, just print str. Okay. So this is how we need to write. Now we'll see what the error it is giving. Change the type of str to Boolean. So it is basically not a Boolean, it is a string itself. So now let us cross check why it is giving an error. So equal to br.readline. And here we need to have one more bracket, okay? So now br.readline will throw some exception, also add IO exception. So now what this contains is br.readline will read the content or read the first line from the text file, store that into str variable. Now the whole thing I'm not equal to null, and then print this str value because this contains a value. Okay. And after that, I will close the buffer reader. Let's say br dot, I can close it. So that's it. So here we have used file reader and buffer reader. And then we have read each and every line from this buffer reader by using read line method. And immediately I printed this str, right? Now let us run this, run as Java application. Now we got the three lines from the text file. Perfectly right. So this is a one approach. And there is one more approach where we can use a file and scanner classes, file and scanner classes combination. Now I'll show you another approach here. Let me just comment the first one. So now here again, I'm going to show you approach two. So here I'll use scanner and file, both file and scanner classes, file and scanner. So let's see how we can do this. So here I need to create one file object. Let's say file equal to new file. And here we need to specify the location of your file. So this is our location of your file along with the name you have to specify. So this is the location of the name. So import this file from java.io package. Now this file is a variable which is representing this old file, test.txt file, right? Now we need to create one scanner class object. Scanner SE is equal to new scanner. Here we need to pass that particular file. So whatever file variable is representing this file, that file we have to pass as a parameter inside the scanner. So scanner also we need to import from java.util package. Now, after that, we have to read each and every line from this file. Currently it is there in SE, right? So now we need to write a loop statement to read the content from the file. So I'll again write a while loop. Inside the while loop, I said SE dot read next line. This is a method. SE is a scanner class object. Okay. SE dot, the method name is read SE dot next line. Sorry, SE dot has next line because we need to put some condition, right? SE dot has next line. That's a method. So let me just line. Yeah. SE dot has next line. So what that mean is, if the SE contains the next line or next line, then this condition becomes true. So as soon as the condition becomes true, inside the loop, I will capture the value from this SE. So for that, I will write state system.out.println. Here I'll say SE.nextLine. This is the method. See this. So has a next line is a conditional command. Okay, it will return either true or false. And has next line means if there is any line in the text file, it returns true. If it is not there, it returns false. So if it is returns true, then we have to read the data by using next line method. So here has next line is a conditional method. And here it is a method which will read the content from the file, se.nextline, right? So here I'm printing that value. So this loop will repeat till it get all the data from this file. So this is another approach. Here we use file object where I specified the location of the file along with the path. Then scanner object I created where I have passed this file parameter. Then I have written one while loop here in which I am verifying if this SE contains has a next line. If it is, then I'm reading the line by using next line method. Okay. So this is approach two. Let me run as Java application. So it is also giving the same output. And apart from this, there is another approach. Instead of writing this looping statement, we can also simplify this without using loop also we can do. That is approach three. Now I'm writing approach three here itself. This is approach three. So in approach three, we don't have any loop. So I'm just commenting this loop and rest of them thing is same. So we have to have file object and where we specify the location of your file and then scanner object, these things are same. But instead of writing the looping statement to read the content from the file, I will use a different method here. Let's say se dot. There is a method called user delimiter. Use delimiter method. So what this method will do is, here we need to specify a regular expression. I'll say //jet. Right. So this is exactly matching each and every line in the notepad. Se dot use delimiter. And after that, I said se dot. I'm just printing here. Let's say system dot out dot println se dot next. And this will give you the whole thing from the text file. So after applying this delimiter, the /backward /jet, then we have to get the content from this se. So se dot next will print the data. So without using loop also, we can read the data from the text file. Now let me run this also, just two lines of code. Right click, run as Java application. So now we got the exact data. So with this, we have seen three different approaches. One approach is by using file reader and buffer reader. And the second approach is using scanner and file. And inside again, we have used one approach is looping statement by using loop statement to read all the lines one by one. And by using a delimiter, we can capture all the lines at one shot. Okay, so these are the different approaches we have to read the data from text file. All right, so that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.